Only God can judge me.
That right? Only God, baby.
Nobody else.
Nobody else.
All you other motherfuckers, get out of my business.
Really?
What's going on, KTF family? You already know what it is. If you don't, it's your boy, Preston, aka Press, aka P. You already know you gotta break it down and hold it. Back with another reaction video. And today, reacting to top 10 SmackDown Live moments from this week. No question of the day. I just wanna say real quick, man, to everybody who support these videos, like, share, subscribe, watch them, you know, come hang out, talk wrestling with us. From the bottom of my heart, thank you, man. I have so much fun making these videos, and I try to put my passion in it, so when y'all watch it, y'all can have fun too, man. Even if it's a bad episode of Raw or SmackDown, you know. So I really hope y'all enjoy it, and thank you again for supporting these videos, man, from the bottom of my heart. So without further ado, let's get to these top 10 moments, bro. See what they're talking about.
This is what's gonna happen. Tonight is the night that you pay.
Okay.
Because even though I am not at 100%, tonight I'm not going to be stopped from making you pay for re-injuring Big E's knee, for attacking Woods week in and week out. Tonight is the night that you pay for all of these things, Kevin.
Let me start off by saying this. When SmackDown first came on, Kevin Owens talked for like an hour. Like, it got to a point where he was just rambling on and on and on. To a point, I think Corey Graves or somebody was just like, are you done yet? And then Kofi came out. As far as Kofi Kingston, man, Big E getting re-injured, I hope that's not an angle to have him turn on Kofi. And Kofi Kingston's title reign, man, I told y'all in previous videos, I thought his title reign would be equivalent to Eddie Guerrero's. Light, fun, relaxed, serious, and just a good time. You know what I'm saying? It's like everything into one. But I feel like they're trying to tweak Kofi's character a little bit and make him so serious. You know? That's not what got Kofi Kingston to the top. What got him to the top is just being goofy, fun, having great matches, and just being entertaining. But now he's just so serious all the time. You know what I mean? But it is what it is, but I feel like he got all this pressure on him to like bring up ratings and stuff. Like, it's not a relaxed environment anymore for him. And that sucks, man. It really does.
Oh, hold on.
We all won in this match. I think we can all agree that we all won seeing Carmella versus Mandy Rose. Now, I said in a previous video, I didn't see Mandy Rose as a champion. Let me correct myself. I absolutely see Mandy Rose as a champion. She's a good talker. She's believable. She has a good finisher. And she's becoming a better worker. She's progressing. You know what I'm saying? She's getting better. She's not just relying on her looks to carry her career. And I respect that, man. And I used to want Sonya Deville to do her own thing, but now I like them together. I like them doing their thing, you know? So shout out to Mandy Rose, man. And Carmella, because Carmella, she getting better too in the ring.
All way for the kick to build the distraction. Mandy Rose is going to get the win thanks to Deville's distraction. This is where it ends. People of Oklahoma are worse than anybody. Oklahoma is a leader in hydraulic fracturing, otherwise known as fracking. They are a leader in deep oil well drilling, and they may cheer that because it brings them a lot of money, but you know what else it brings them? It brings them earthquakes!
Hey, Daniel Bryan, we talking, bro.
Infinitely more earthquakes than Oklahoma has ever had.
Hey, he's got to stay focused.
Hey, wait a minute.
What else, Bailey? Talk.
I
and Charlotte Flair's going back in after Bayley.
Oh, watch out from behind.
Lacey Evans and O'Connor Rule.
Wait a minute, Lacey. The official Lacey could have had it right there. The cover and a kick up by Bayley.
Bayley counters.
Bayley's got a cover. Bayley's beating Evans.
Bayley, what else?
Here is your winner.
Hey, shout out to Bayley, man. Bayley out here doing her thing, man. She always wanted to be on SmackDown. Now she on SmackDown. And now she the women's champion. You know what I'm saying? It sucks that Sasha couldn't be here being on SmackDown doing her thing too. You know? But I mean, it is what it is. But I think they was going to keep her on Raw anyway.
The SmackDown Women's Champion, Bayley.
What is Truth thinking? He's interrupted Shane McMahon appreciation.
R-Truth, no matter what happens, is going to go down as the greatest 24/7 champion of all time. I believe that shit. This 24/7 championship idea, it's a great idea. It's brilliant. It's genius. Like, for real, for real. Congratulations. I just wish somebody would redesign the title. That's all I want. Just redesign the title. Please.
Tonight.
It's not necessarily the best time, Truth.
Gonna defend the title anytime, anywhere.
I think Truth just realized he was only running from one.
Truth into the cover. R-Truth has success.
And can we just acknowledge that R-Truth was on SmackDown with a title, and he hit a fatality, and he got the victory.
Fully defended the 24/7 title.
And still the 24/7 champion, R-Truth.
Hey, congratulations, R-Truth.
I don't even know where to begin with this.
Damn, son, where'd you find this?
Okay.
I know it's Elias, McIntyre, and Shane McMahon.
Well, maybe if Truth had shown the
problem. Hey, sometimes it be like that, bro.
This wouldn't be happening.
Well, so I don't think Truth had any idea what he was rolling out here into. He's just trying to defend his title.
I rarely think Truth has any idea about anything.
Fist away.
Another big Scottish psychopath, Drew McIntyre. The wild card from Raw. Load it up.
Fatality.
Elias has a cover.
Elias is the new 24/7 champion.
Wow.
Here is your winner and the new 24/7 champion.
R-Truth, when he lost the title, I was a little bit sad because he's been doing such a great job and he's been making it so entertaining and so fun. But when Elias won, I was happy because he deserved it, man. Like I've been saying, put the Intercontinental United States, give this man something. You know, give this man a title, something. And he finally caught this and I was just kind of happy for him. You know, I was kind of interested to see what they did with him. Him being with Shane McMahon. It is what it is, man.
What is this, sad?
Lacey Evans from behind.
Well, this is a short-lived alliance.
Hey, wait a minute. Oh, no. Oh, McIntyre went for the Claymore and missed.
Yo, Drew McIntyre with the L. I think that has to be the biggest L I've seen in the WWE since Titus O'Neil.
Titus O'Neil.
Titus had a very busy week here in Saudi Arabia. He's had dinner with many princes and very important people. And he
Oh my God, what the heck? What did Titus just... I can't believe what I just saw. Did that really happen?
Oh my God.
Oh yes. My God.
That was epic, man. Damn. Mr. Flawless Victory missed the Claiborne kick. Sometimes it be like that, bro.
Shane McMahon retreating from a fight with Roman Reigns.
Zayn wants no part of Reigns.
Right. Up, back inside the ring, it's Elias. Heads up, spinner. Cover. Reigns and Truth win.
Here are your winners, R-Truth and Roman Reigns.
Kofi able to counter it.
Fatality.
He caught him. Kingston caught him.
Cover.
He caught Owens. No way.
Kofi. He caught him. The victory.
What else?
How the hell did he do
that?
Here
is your winner, the WWE Champion, Kofi Kingston.
Finish him.
Oh, no.
Fatality.
Another spear from Reigns. Wait a minute, guys. Wait a minute. The match is over. The 24/7 championship. What's going on?
Truth, cover him, Truth.
Hey, when this happened, I did not expect this shit, bro. I was happy that R-Truth was 24/7 champion. When he lost to Elias, I was sad, but then I was happy, Elias, that he won the title. But then when I seen this, I got happy again, bro. They play with my emotions. You know what I'm saying? It's like listening to Metallica song Orion. It just plays with your emotions, man.
Truth is taking a hell of a beating here tonight, but Roman saying cover him, Truth. Truth has won the title back. He did it again.
Here is your winner and the new 24/7 champion.
Well, there you have it, man. SmackDown was decent, you know what I'm saying? The best part of SmackDown, though, was the 24/7 championship. You know, the 24/7 championship. I like where they're going with Shane McMahon, Elias, Drew McIntyre. Like, I feel like they're actually building a faction and creating some type of a huge storyline. But they're building it up slow. And I as a fan, I appreciate the slow build-up. You know what I'm saying? But, you know what I'm saying? Like I said, it just seems like SmackDown and Raw are slowly but surely changing things. You know what I'm saying? Not all at once, but it just seems like it's starting to get a little bit better. You know, I can see the little changes in it, which I'm happy if that's the case. You know what I mean? But overall, SmackDown, it was decent. I think Raw was the better show, though. I really do. This week. What y'all think, though? What y'all think? Let me know what you think about this video in the comments down below. If you're new here, welcome to the pack. If not, you already know what it is, bro. It's your boy, Preston. As always, let me keep the faith. Until next time. Peace.
Against all odds, hoping my true motherfuckers know. This be the realest shit I ever wrote. Against all odds, up in the studio, getting blowed. The truest shit I ever spoke.